Everyone, welcome to the next lecture of the series. So in the previous lecture we ended on stock and flow variables. Now for today we will be studying types of circular flow, wherein we have two types of circular flow. One is real flow and another one is money flow. So when I talk about real flow, now the word real, emphasize on the word real here. The word real here means something physical. Okay, that is, we are talking about something real, which is tangible or physical. So that is flow of factor services from households to firms and corresponding flow of goods and services from firms to houses. I'm talking about the real things which are involved in this process now. Factor services which are flowing from households to firms. I have told you initially only that households supply land, labor, capital, and enterprise to firms. The four factors of production which we have. So from households to firms here, in this diagram you can see land, labor, capital, and enterprise is being flowed, and then firms are supplying goods and services to households. So there is this circular flow wherein we have tangible things involved with us. Households are supplying their land, labor, capital, and enterprise, and in return, firms are giving them goods and services. So this is what is meant by real flow, which is also called physical flow. Only exchange of goods and services between two sectors is involved here. No money is involved. Only goods and services exchange is involved here. No money is being involved. This is important. This is important to remember that no money is being involved here. Only goods and services is being exchanged between the two sectors. Now, this flow is determining the magnitude of growth in the economy. How this is determining the magnitude of growth? That more factor services households will be supplying to firms here, more will be the volume of production, because as many factor services firms will have, as many factors of production firms will have, more they will be contributing to the production of the firm. And so the volume of production will increase. When the volume of production will increase, our economic growth will automatically speed up. Yeah, when investments are in economy are increased, when production is increased, more people, more goods are being produced, more people are being hired, more income is being generated, more income is being earned by people, and so automatically our economic growth would boost up. Our economic growth will be speed up. Okay, are you understanding here? So this is what is meant by real flow. I'll recapitulate once more. Real flow is flow of factor services. Real things are involved here, which is visible, which is tangible. Tangible things are involved here, okay, which is visible. And corresponding flow of goods and services. So this is a circular diagram which you need to memorize. This may be asked in exam. No money is involved here, and this is determining the magnitude of growth. How? Because more factor services will lead to more volume of production, and in turn will boost up the economic growth. This is one type of circular flow. The another one is money flow. Now, when I talk about money flow, money, the word itself is being included here, money. Okay, so that means here money will be involved. Yeah, so I have told you in the previous lecture that firms pay factor income, firms pay factor payments to factors of production, and factors of production receive factor incomes. That is, individual receive factor income. So that is only what is involved here in money flow. What happens is flow of factor payments from firms to household. From firms to household, there is a flow of factor payment which is happening for their factor services, and the corresponding flow of consumption expenditure from household to firms. So firms are giving household these factor payments, that is rent, wage, interest and profit, rent to land, wage to labor, interest to capital and profit to entrepreneur. And then after receiving this income, households are spending this as their consumption expenditure on goods and services, because this is what their need is. This is what household need. Household need is goods and services. And there are they spending on goods and services. And from where they are purchasing these goods and services? From firms. Okay, so there is the circular flow here. And this circular flow involves money. Payment is being done by firms to household, and then they are in turn spending it on the firm's goods and services only. So the previous one was physical flow. This one is nominal flow because it involves exchange of money between two sectors. Exchange of money is being involved. There is no physical tangible thing which is being exchanged. Only money is being exchanged. This is important. Okay. Next, let's study this difference between real flow and money flow. So when I say real flow, this is flow of goods and services. I've already told you tangible things are involved, physical things are involved, things which are visible. Money flow, flow of money between firms and households. Kind of exchange. It involves exchange of goods and services, and money flow involves exchange of money. Difficulty in exchange. So see, in real flow, there can be difficulties in exchange. We all of us know about barter system where exchange of goods take place. Double coincidence of wants is there. Yeah, coincidence of wants is there in barter system. So this is what is the problem with real flow. That is, there can be difficulty in exchanging the goods. What good I need may not be with you. Okay, so there is this difficulty involved in real flow. Whereas in money flow, there is no such difficulty involved. You can exchange everything from money. Money can buy anything. Yeah. Alternative name, physical flow, nominal. This we have already studied. So this is about two types of circular flow, real flow and money flow. Okay. I'll be taking two sector economy next video. Stay tuned.